right. Hello, everyone. Thank you for giving me the opportunity to present today. My name is Waseel, and I'm lead SharePoint architect and administrator. I've been working with SharePoint for nearly two decades, starting with SharePoint 23 and continuing through every version since 2007, 10, 13, 16, 19, subscription edition and SharePoint Online. Today, I'm excited to share a solution that brings AI directly into the SharePoint experience and AI power employee help desk built using Microsoft Copilot Studio. As businesses continue to evolve and embrace digital transformation, the demand for faster, more efficient employee support has never been greater. This session, I will walk you through how AI technology, when integrated with Microsoft 365 and related platform, can streamline help desk operation, reduce response time, and ultimately improve employee satisfaction. This chatbot is fully embedded in SharePoint Online and enable user to ask questions, open or check service requests, escalate incident, and even assign ticket to specific help desk staff, all through a natural conversation. I'll walk you through its key capabilities, show how it uses structured knowledge within SharePoint, and demonstrate how it can support full support lifecycle right from the SharePoint interface. I'm looking forward to your question and feedback. Let's get started. So this solution is built using Microsoft Copilot Studio, and it's embedded directly within the SharePoint Online environment. It's always available and allows user to ask questions, open ticket, or check the status of their request all without leaving SharePoint. Here are the core features of the chatbot. It can carry on a natural conversation with user, answer question using co-rooted knowledge from SharePoint, escalate to human support when needed, and track incident status all from one interface. To ensure accuracy, the chatbot pulls information from a structured knowledge source base that lives within SharePoint. This content is added as a knowledge source in Copilot, which ensures the response are reliable, current, and contextual. If the bot cannot answer a question, it automatically offers to open a service request. The user just provides a brief title and description, and the chatbot creates the ticket directly from the chat interface, streamlining the escalation process. One helpful feature is targeted assignment. If the user knows who should handle the issue, they can tell the bot to assign it to a specific help desk employee. This is especially useful for recurring or familiar issues and speed up the resolution. User can also check the status of their previously submitted ticket by simply asking the bot if it fetched the latest update from the help desk system and display it right in the chat. This reduces follow-up emails and increases transparency. The help desk bot reduces the workload on IT teams by automating repetitive tasks. It improves the user experience by enabling self-service support and ensure the full incident lifecycle, ask, escalate, assign, and track happens all within SharePoint. Now I'll show you a live demo. You will see how user can interact with the chatbot, escalate an issue, assign it to someone, and check a previous ticket status all in a seamless experience inside SharePoint. And if you had some time, I will show you the backend configuration and the Copilot Studio, how it's configured and how the agent was created back in the Copilot Studio. All right, as you can see, I'm currently logged in into SharePoint employee help desk site. This site acts as a central hub for IT-related information. At the top, you scroll to the top, you can see there's the navigation bar that connects this site to other site collection, making it via hub, making it easy for user to explore and browse related content. So, user can log in and browse all these other site collection where it hosts some of the IT related information. And let's say user log in and has a question, and instead of calling or emailing the support, they can interact with the chatbot. So if I scroll down, you would see the chatbot icon here. Here's the chatbot. So it's embedded, it is built, created in Copilot Studio, published and embedded into the SharePoint site. If let's click on it. Refresh one time. All right. So before we interact with the chatbot and ask us to authenticate, after successful authentication, it will greet us and allow us to start interacting with the chatbot. I'm going to click on login, go through the authentication. It will provide me a validation code. I'm going to copy the validation code and paste, send, or hit enter. And then, as you can see, the chat started to greet, which is all customizable back in the Copilot Studio. And it gave me a prompt. What can I ask? So if I click on the prompt, so I can help answer any variety of general IT question. I can also help create lookup service requests that you have opened. So there are other prompts that's already there. Now I want to ask a question from the chatbot that has an answer from the connected knowledge source. Let's say, The chatbot should respond with an accurate answer based on information available on the knowledge source. So this information was pulled. This is the answer. Password should be changed at least every 90 days, and the previous 5 password cannot be used. And as you can see, here is the reference, and this information was pulled from this policy document that's hosted under the IT policy sites over here in the site collection. Now I will demonstrate, let's say, what happens when a user asks a question that's not covered in the knowledge base? As you can see, the chatbot responded back that I'm unable to answer because this is not, it couldn't find it in the knowledge source. And it's prompting me if I want to open a service request. I would say yes. Okay, so now I have to provide a brief title for the service request. And now it's asking me to provide a description. And then it confirmed this is the title, description. You want to create the incidents. I'll click create. And this incident has been successfully created. Now let's verify if this incident was successfully created and ServiceNow. So I'll copy this request incident number, and on the next tab, I have moved this. I have ServiceNow open here, and we'll verify the, oh, it's here. Let me log in. I'll paste the incident number and search for it. Yeah, so here you go. I did find this incident was created, and we can see the date and time. Now, let's say I want to assign this incident with the help of the chatbot to somebody that I have worked with in the past. So I'm going to ask the chatbot to assign this incident. Come back to this screen and ask the chatbot. provide the incident number, and then it would ask me for the email address of the staff. So I'll provide the email address. Now if you go back to the previous, the ServiceNow windows, the incident was assigned to an employee, all from the chat window. And let's say if an employee came, staff came and updated the ticket, resolved the ticket. So the status is in progress. I will go ahead, mark this as a resolve. I have to put my notes. Resolution code. Resolve. Now, if I go ask for the status of the incident, the bot would go ahead, pull that information and display it for me. I have to provide the incident number. Scroll down. So the status resolved, it was assigned, and all the title, description, and the date it was open. And I don't know if I have a few minutes, I can show the backend how this bot was configured. So here I'm logged in the Copilot Studio, and this is the bot agent, Copilot agent. You could customize the logo, which I have customized here on my end. And this is the instruction provided to the bot. And as we scroll down, these are the knowledge source. And you can see one of the connector I have configured is the ServiceNow. And it was, here's the setting for the bot. One setting that I wanted to show is the security and authentication, which I have it manually and configured. And then it's published to a channel, to the website, demo website, and then you can get the code and embed it into your SharePoint site.